Hold on, hold on. I like you too. I promise I will not release the video of you and the farm animals, I promise. Again. Okay, kids. You are on video. How cool is this, huh?
Came to America, I couldn't speak a word of English. know.
Click the vowels and all that. And English became my third, fourth language. Spoken other languages before. And I still do. And so when I came to America, I discovered comic books. I was 8 before I was 9. See what I did there? Thank you. Just 3 people for that. The very first comic book I saw was World's Finest. Robin, Batman, Superman. I'd never heard of them. And all of a sudden, this guy's flying through the air. He's dressed in bright and colored stuff. And this other guy was a grown-up rich guy with a teenager who was living with him. And it was all very mixed. I'm trying to do the joke, but you get the inference. Rich guy with a little guy. And I couldn't make heads or tails of it, but I was fascinated and then hooked. And then I started buying the Timely Atlas monster books. Jack Kirby, Dick Ayers, and all that stuff, Stan Lee. And literally, within, well, let's see, 62, and by 78, by, I guess that's 16 years later, we had our own comic book. It's that fast. Trying to learn English fast, and even in those slow days of covered wagons, put out our first comic book, and instead of 25 cents or 10 cents, it was $1.50. And it became the largest comic book of all time for the day until Todd McFarlane's Spider-Man in 89. And it's been a long, long love affair with the panel graphic art form, as Stan Lee used to say. So we've had Marvel Comics, and we've had Image, McFarlane, Dark Horse, and IDW, and more, and Platinum Comics, and now the new history, present history, is Diana puts out 2 titles, the Kiss Comics, and the Demon. I'm the bad guy, I'm the one with the long tongue. Your mom, ask your mommy, she'll tell you. And, by the way, what's your mom's name?
My mom is actually here, to be honest with you.
What's her name?
Charlene.
Oh, I remember her. She was backstage. Hi, Shirley. She's waving.
It's embarrassing.
And I also publish Simmons Comics Group, which has Gene Simmons' House of Horrors, Zipper, and Dominatrix. Dominatrix is sort of, it's a, sort of like what it is, but she's on the run. And it's very much CIA meets TNA. See what I did there? And that's being developed into a motion picture by Arclight Films, which makes very good food. I have a joint venture with those guys, and so that'll come out soon. Hey, instead of sitting up here, you know, gee, I've had to talk to them. Can I come down there? How do I do it? Here, hold this. By the way, you know why I wear shades even when it's dark?
You were my biggest nightmare when I was 4 years old, so, as the demon. But I grew to love you, so.
Well, there's a joke in there, but I'm not going to do it.
Thank you, Gene. Gene, I just want to say, even though you have your arms around my wife, I'd be honored if you took her in any way that you wanted.
Again?
Again, but this time I'd like to watch.
Oh! Would she be my Canadian content?
1/3 needs to be Canadian content. I just want to say you're the coolest guy.
Cut it out with the fucking jokes. I'm in charge. You realize I have a newfie for a wife. Shannon is a newfie. And stay where you're at and I'll come where you're too. Bye.
I'm a teacher and I dressed as you 1 year for Halloween. And it was the coolest time just dressing as you. Because all of the students want to make a photograph of me in the jeans of its costume. And that's cool. Anyone resembles you, they want to introduce your dating.
I have the utmost respect for you, not just because of your good looks and your wonderful family. And that's a sneaky way of getting some respect myself, because I was a sixth grade teacher in Spanish Harlem in New York City.
I actually knew that, because my wife is your biography, Kiss and Make Up.
She wrote my biography, Kiss and
She has a copy of your biography.
Well, God bless you. Thank you for buying my mom another house. Settle down, your children are here. Well, it was a pleasure to talk to me. Chicks, hold on a second, stand up. I want you to be a leader. I want you to take my microphone and take charge.
Gene, I would like to know if you would consider running for president of the United States of America.
What's that? You're very sweet. I wouldn't be the kind of... first of all, they don't pay any money. But and all, democracy is the best political system we've ever had. It really started with the Greeks and everything. But it's a messy affair because you have mostly professional politicians who self-mandated to get re-elected. Do what's right for you. You know, it's political. Even if they know that it's for the greater good, their party will dictate that they'll vote against the other side of the one that will see. So, politics is a messy affair. I'd rather be your benevolent dictator.
I'm all for it.
But I would be a serious guy. I would ask for a very limited term. 6 months, give me a year, no money, and here's what I do. Pedophiles will be put to death.
Yes! Yes!
If you commit a crime with a gun, 7-Eleven or Timmy's, if you come in with a gun, for the rest of your life you're going to be digging holes in the North Pole. Because anybody who holds a gun in the commitment of a crime risks killing you. They're on crack, or I forgot to tie my shoelaces, or the dog ate my homework, or I have a dysfunctional family. I don't give a fuck. You point a gun at an innocent person, you deserve to be away from society so we can all work hard and live normal lives without having the parasites on us. So if you can't get straight off of drugs and everything, you're in Alaska or in the North Pole away from society. Why are we babysitting people who are going to rob from their mothers and kill their children, do all this horrible stuff, and then try to figure out what's wrong with them psychologically? I am a reading. What's wrong with them psychologically? Figure that out at the North Pole. Let everybody else work hard and love their families and not be tortured by parasites. So you don't want me to be there because I would fix all your problems. I wouldn't limit the power of unions. That's going to make me very uncomfortable. because all your jobs are going overseas, because every company wants to be profitable. So unions want to help, but the jobs are disappearing, so now it's like you stretch the rubber band too much and it snaps. People are out of work, but I got you an extra dollar per month. Yeah, that's nice, but they're answering our phones in India. So, you got to think about it. What's the greater good for everybody? And I think politicians should be doing their job for free as public service without retirement plan, all this stuff. So don't put me in charge, because I'll make your life wonderful. Oh, picture show. Did you just say sorry?
Sorry to be a bummer.
You know, I love Canadians so much that I gave my only begotten son, oh no, that's another story, that I've been all over the world, and it's the only country on earth that literally apologizes to people who just got into the country for weather. Or if my cup from Timmy's isn't warm enough. Or, here, I'll give you a Canadian conversation. Start talking to me. Go ahead. Sorry? Sorry?
At your concert.
Sorry? Did you and I ever... Your glasses are funny, huh? I want some little ones, because they say cooler stuff. Come on over. Harley, what is your name?
Katie.
Look how powerful your voice is. See, you took it. So take this microphone and be here, because we need women and young ladies to take charge and take it away from the stupid men. You guys should be leading the country. Because we make war all the time and we make stupid decisions based on the chemicals in our body, testosterone, and you have much greater wisdom.
Yeah.
Mommy, he's a weird man. I don't know what he's talking about. Okay, take this microphone and talk to them and tell them what's on your mind. Go.
Okay, he is a rock star, and my dad dressed up as him once.
I dressed up like him too.
Yeah, I...
Okay, so here's some important stuff, because I also used to teach sixth grade, just like your dad. And so what you learn in school, and I've written books about it, and by the way, I have another book coming out in a month called On Power from HarperCollins. And what they teach you in school, unfortunately, you can't apply in public life, because you don't learn what's capitalism, what's the price of goods, due diligence, what's taxes, what's a mortgage, how much is the price of marriage, more importantly, how much is the price of divorce. Oh, I'm in like the Clinton. And, but by the way, it's the only one. I will go to my death with this ring on my finger. Or should it kill me? Whatever's first. Very important. I want you to promise yourself that even though you're not going to learn the stuff you need to learn in life from school, because just because of 1848, the French and Indian War, and the fort, and the Montreal, and General Wolfe, see, I know Canadian history too. Montreal. So, and the French and Indian War was not a war with the French or the Indians. It was the French and the Indians against the English. Did you get all that?
No.
You did. But more importantly, none of that will help you earn a living and feed your family and do that. So the promise you have to make in front of me and for yourself and for your family is never stop learning. Do you promise?
Okay.
Okay, and now... there's no excuse for not learning. You know what this is?
What?
It's a kiss cell phone.
Oh, I...
But everything you need to know is on here, right?
Not everything.
Not everything?
Not everything.
What's not in here?
Well, she can't learn love, she can't learn respect. She's learning it's her family. And we're teaching her as best as we can, and very important in our household is we teach her to love and respect minorities.
Ooh.
And all different cultures are welcome in our home and in our country. And that's more important than, you know, going out after the next thing and what the internet says. And there's a lot of hate for Trump in our household.
And people who feel otherwise, it's their country too. So, you know, agree to disagree. I did an op-ed piece for the Toronto Sun yesterday, as a matter of fact, and my editorial was, treat each other the way Johnson, the Marcus Brigade, and all the bad guys in the Middle East, they don't make a distinction between conservative and Republican and liberals, because you're all Canadian, and because you're all free. And because we respect our women, and the aspirations are limitless, and you have all the freedom in the world, and they don't. They're jealous. You have it all, and they don't understand why there are leaders in the world and no more women. So agree to disagree, but belong to the most important political party, the Canadian political party, the Maple Leaf Party. Agree to disagree, but don't hate each other, because do you have any brothers and sisters, Mommy?
Yes, one brother.
Do you always get along with him?
No.
Defense rest, Your Honor. Okay. But I'm here to tell you that those are the important things. None of that will pay your rent.
That's right, I would agree with that.
Which is why I'm saying everything is here to help you pay your rent, make you understand how to make money, to feed your family, buy your mom the hip operation she needs, and all that stuff. And more importantly, if you find the right relationship with this, because it's free, you will get the kind of respect, access to all information. Here, let's try this.
Siri,
what do you call me?
I do not either.
Now, when was the last time you got that much respect? So even though I'm joking around, I want you to get serious young. I'm an only child. I wasn't born in this country. How old are you?
10. But how old I was.
So I came here when I was 8 and a half, and I couldn't speak English. To the band.
Pardon me?
To the band.
To the band.
It's Portuguese. If anybody speaks German? Stand up. Was ist dein Name?
Mein Name ist Taras Kaczkowski.
Du bist von Frankfurt oder Berlin?
Ich bin von Saskatoon, Saskatchewan.
Ich habe Deutsch in der Hauptschule gelernt. Ich habe in Deutsch auf der Schule vor 6 Monaten.
Ja.
Ich spreche gut.
Da, ja.
Hochdeutsch?
Hochdeutsch, ja.
What I'm trying to get to say in German is you're a powerful and attractive man, Jane.
I'm not fooling, unfortunately, to think of that often.
Why the hell are you taller and bigger than I am? Gene Simmons, no.
You're going to do the costume, you know, to the platforms. So even though I'm 6'6" tall, without them, you got to do the platforms.
Oh yeah? Well, my son Nick is 6'8".
That's powerful in the track.
Tell them what I'm going to say to your son. I'll speak in Hungarisch, a bit in Hebrewisch, natürlich English, and a bit in Japanisch.
He says that he speaks English and Hebrew and a little bit of Japanese and some Hungarian.
Fluent.
Wow.
Fluently, yes.
Well, that was wonderful talking to me.
Yes, it was.
Thank you. Vielen Dank.
Vielen Dank. Ja.
Tschüss. You want to do something? Do it well. Get back to what your moms and dads and the previous generations had. It was called pride. The little Italian shoemaker who would take the time to fix your shoes, he would never look at his watch. It's called pride and craftsmanship. Now everybody's looking at their watch or looking at their, how many women have fallen into the fountains and malls when they're too busy trying to figure out what to shop on Amazon with their high heels and their seat flip. How many women have sued McDonald's because their coffee was too hot? That's Americans, that's right. So, this stuff about me, you can find that out and everything. I'm more interested in you, because we wouldn't be here without you, especially the little ones. We're all going to go away soon. Some of us quicker than the others. And whatever we do, the seeds we plant, they're going to be taken over this world. And I swear to you, I'm convinced that our moral, ethical responsibility is while we're here and before we leave this earth, to leave this earth a little bit better than when we came into it. These things need to be said, and it's important. And I've shared these opinions with, I'm going to show you a photo, it will tell us, I'm sorry to bother you. Watch me stop that right away. What's your name? How old are you? And is all this noise just because you're not getting attention? By the way, he gave me the finger. Everybody does. So, would you mind standing? Thank you. So you know my hand gesture, how does it look? You know that? Yeah. What with the thumb out? That means I love you in sign language. Who is this?
Oh.
What's he doing?
Your signal?
Who is this?
Dalai Lama.
What's he doing?
Your signal?
Who's with the Dalai Lama with his arm around? What am I doing?
Your signal?
Yeah. So the reason for that, I'm telling you that, is it's actually kind of a cool thing. People call it devil this and devil that. But they're in the peanut gallery. They're not qualified to understand anything. This means that all the sign languages around the world, because there are different languages, it means I love you. It means I love you. When I told him about what it means from his assistant, he said, what is this? Well, Gene Simmons said, oh, they just got it. Yeah, I was there. Oh, that day, what does this mean? It means I love you. He goes, oh, I like that. More this and less, it's all about me. Hi, everybody, I'm important. It's not a bad thing to do each other. Everybody does this and stuff. They have no idea what this means. By the way, you know what the history of this is?
Oh, yeah.
When the Normans and the Saxons were at war, the French and the English, the French won. The Normans invaded the Saxons. So they used to kill each other. Human beings do that. And they had archers, like bow and arrow. And the French, the Normans, were beating the English. And then the English invented the longbow. They were taller than the bowmen. And before they would shoot, so their arrows got to the French easier. The French arrows wouldn't go that far because the bows were smaller. So the English would hold up their two fingers like this. You're about to die. They would do that, and when the French, if they caught some of the archers, they cut off those two fingers. So Churchill, I know you're a millennial, but it's before your time. Have you heard of Winston Churchill? Because you millennials out there, the earth existed before 5 years ago. Yes. Prime Minister Trudeau is not your current. There was a former Prime Minister Trudeau. And so Winston Churchill turned it around to Herr Hitler, who he was saying, and he was doing like V for victory. But what he was really say is up. And so today in England, when they do this, it means what?
Victory.
No, it doesn't mean victory. When somebody does that, it means up here, yeah. So to me, yes, it does. Anybody from England will tell you, am I right?
You know, I'm in. Here I am, what I was thinking about. Oh, yeah.
Am I right? Go ahead, catch this, tell them what it means. If you wanted to be in a grunge band, world famous, where would you go? didn't do the research. How do I become a successful elephant hunter? I'm in South America, I've got my guns, and I've got a tank, and I can do it. You're on the wrong continent, buddy. To start with, the right thing, at the right place, and at the right time. Do you have the right thing?
Yes.
Says who?
My own heart.
I'm telling you, harsh. It's harsh out there. Yet life is not the, you know, don't hurt my feelings. It's called business, not feelings. So if you can identify other answers, let me take off the asshole glasses so you can see. That's an affectation. So that's sort of the important sneakers you wear. So it's this. It's all affectation. Because we're trying to impress each other. So if you want to do something, try to identify in your mind who else is doing it. You can't do it all on your own. The mountain is going to be much steeper, much harder, because you'll be the only one who does that. It's not impossible, just much harder. So if I wanted to start a restaurant for food, I would probably do Italian, but I probably wouldn't go nationwide with mukbang. You know what mukbang is? I think it's Inuit. Whale blubber.
No, delightful.
But some people like it. 12. So the chance, again, if you want to succeed, you know, there are Christian ministries that don't care how many people do it, they just do it because it's in their heart. If you're interested in a career, you have to, it's a business, which means you want to make money, which means how many people are buying that kind of thing, which means if I'm starting a restaurant, I'm not going to sell much money. Which might be delicious to begin with, but they won't. So whatever your message, can you write songs?
Yes. I've written songs the last 5 years.
Play an instrument?
Seven.
Wow. What instrument?
Guitar, ukulele, bass, saxophone, drums, recorder, harmonica.
Speechless. Okay, so I'm going to say something that's not going to appear to you as an Antonian. Okay, move. Because if you want fresh air, wonderful people, a loving environment, you come here. You don't go to New York. You're not going to find that there. Because the competition there is like the UN is there, the Fashion Avenue, and the business of Wall Street. So they're all competing, but there's a whole lot of money there. You want to go fracking? You know what that is?
Yeah.
Fracking is when the oil guys go up and they break through rock to get to the, you know, the oil and all that stuff. You come to buy some property in Edmonton, that's what it is. And then go up north and make a lot of money. But if you want to be in fracking, you don't go to New York. They've never heard that word. So it sounds like you want to do something. You may have the right thing. Clearly sound like you're prepared, you've got all the due diligence and business talk. You're in the wrong place. Okay. Where do I think you should go? Who do you admire?
You and Stevie Nicks.
We're worlds apart. I used to go with Stevie. But we are worlds apart, what we do. We started in New York, she started in L.A. Davenport, Iowa.
Definitely not.
And not Moncton.
No.
Although I love Moncton. You know who goes to Moncton? You know, wonderful people on it. The American astronauts actually go to Moncton because it most closely resembles the terrain of the moon. Not a joke. So, yeah.
Okay, Gene Simmons, can I have a kiss? Thank you!
Sit down and stop stealing the show.
Well, I think we have another panel starting in like 1 minute, so we do have, I know. But of course you can see Gene on the stage here later today. Tickets available still on Ticketmaster outlet. And also I want to say, because I'm from Saskatoon, Gene just went down to the Barrett Jackson auction and brought back $450,000 for the Children's Hospital of Saskatchewan. So I want to